teach you guys how I use KRITA and like just a little rundown on how it works. I'm a little nervous to be shooting this YouTube video because this is my first YouTube video like ever. So please bear with me. And I swear, KRITA, it might look complicated to some, but I swear it is not. Please bear with me. Okay, so when you open up KRITA, it should look like this. So first thing you're gonna do is press open file and you're gonna get the template that you're gonna be using. I'm gonna be using this advanced template. It looks like this, very beautiful. So first rule of designing, always make a new layer. Please, please, please always make a new layer, because if you draw onto one layer, wow. If you draw onto one layer like this, it's stuck to each other forever. You won't be able to move it if you make a mistake. Yeah. So what you do is you press this beautiful plus sign and now you can move it separately. It's a lifesaver. Please, please, please listen. Okay. So I'm only going to be going over the brushes and tools that I use because I only use like half of this program and I think that's all that really matters. So first obviously is just like the select tool, and then third, oh my god, it's 2 a.m. No, it's not even 2 a.m. It's 1 a.m. I cannot think. But now we have the text tool, just hold and drag and you can just type in whatever you want. Let's type in my group name. Here are the fonts, bold, regular. Here's the font size. Here's the color of the font and color picker. And yeah, and then you just have to press save and then you can press close. And here's your font. Then this is the brush tool, and you can also just press B on your keyboard to get to it like this. Here's the opacity, here's the size. That's all for the brush tool. And the brushes that I use are brush one or basic one, and then I use this tool, this soft eraser tool, only when I'm like shading. It's great for shading. Let's go back to this brush and let's say I want to erase this. You can press this or you can press E on your keyboard. There you go. Another tool I use is this con swab looking tool, Blender Blur. I use this for shading as well. And then my favorite tool ever, which I use every day, is this beautiful stamp sparkles. It makes everything look amazing and beautiful and shiny. Then this is the line tool. And for this, you just have to hold and drag, and you can make straight lines in any way, shape, or form. And then third is, why am I saying third? Okay. Next is this square tool. You just have to hold and drag. And then circle, same thing. And then this is like, just press, click, 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 make any shape you want, click, click. And then when you're done making the shape, double click. And there you go. What did I do? So now, this is, I don't know what this is called. This is the, I'm not gonna say that word, no. So I use this a lot. I use this like when tracing out what I wanna make. So like neck hole, bottom of the shirt, etc. Next is this tool. So this just like can make it small, you can make it wide, you can make it long, you can make it, you can rotate it. I don't know. I don't know what that does. But yeah, that's that. And then this is the like select tool, dragging. You can do whatever you want with that. Here's the color selector, color picker. I was shooting this before and I said color pickle. It was really embarrassing. But let's say I want this beautiful red color. Just click it and now you have it. So now I'm going to, okay, so then this paint bucket tool, I don't really use it. So like, let's say I want to fill in this, then you just click in between it, I guess. And then next we have the select tool, which you just hold and drag. And like, let's say I wanted to select this little piece, just copy and paste. A new layer. And then this is just like a circle version of it. And then this is, I don't know, but you just have to click, 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 and then double click when you're done. There you go. And then this I call the lasso tool. You can just draw out the shape you want. There you go. And then this is the magic wand. Okay, let's say I want to get rid of this whole red background. I just have to click it and then press Control X and it's gone. She's kind of gone. Okay, now we're going to be going over like this top section. So I have this, and I want to make it look more textury. I want it to be more realistic, have more depth. I'll press fill patterns, and these are the two main patterns that I use the most. But let's say I use this. Oh my god, see, I'm not even listening to my own number one rule. I'm using the same layer. But make a new layer, obviously, draw, and then right click, press group, then quick clipping group, and draw. Like, it doesn't matter, just, it could be a small dot, it doesn't matter, just draw something and press edit and then fill with pattern. If you don't draw something on the layer that you're putting the pattern on, the pattern won't show up. So, well, at least for me, I don't know. And oh my god, no, it's covering my beautiful design. Press this CX and wow, it's like magic. And then you can turn down the opacity, or you can press overlay, which is what I usually do, but it's barely showing because of how bright this red is. It is hurting my eyes. But let's do like this color so I can show you guys. Yeah, there you go. Beautiful. Okay. Now, to merge this all together, right click, merge group. That's it. And then this is just like your colors, which this thing is also over here. So you can just choose your colors, or you can color pick. And then this, so like, let's say I wanted to do like stitching for a shirt or polka dots or something. I press this, edit brush settings, and this only works on the brush one or whatever, the one I'm using, pretty sure. Press spacing, then go to like about 7, and you can do this, or for stitching you go to like 50 or something, and it does that, and it looks super cool. This is just like over here. This is the erase tool, opacity, size, and then this is the mirroring tool. So like, let's say I was drawing the neck collar, it would, oh god, let me put it back to normal. It would do this on both sides. Super dope. Or what you could do is you could draw this, and then this is the duplicating button. Duplicate that, you have a different layer of it. Press layer, transform, mirror layer horizontally, and just connect it like that. You could do that, or the easy way out, which is obviously the mirroring tool, my favorite. Oops, my favorite. And then this is the, I don't know what that's called, but yeah, it looks like that. And then over here, we went through this, we went over this, add layer, duplicate, delete layer, and then these are all the brushes. Let's say I have this and I want it to be green, press filter, adjust, HSV adjustment, and you can just change the hue. I want a beautiful green, and then saturation, dark. Oh, I love this green color. Lightness. Yeah, there you go. And then let's say I wanted an easy way of blurring without having to blur it myself with the blurring tool. You can press filter, blur, Gaussian blur, and there you go. Blur that to your desire. And I think that's it for everything. I think I covered pretty much everything, just like the basics. Okay, thank you guys for watching. If you have like any recommendations of what you want me to film, or just any ideas or suggestions in general, please comment them or just tell me, because I know what I'm going to do with this channel, but I don't know what specifically I want to do. I know I want to make designing videos, but I don't know on what, if that makes sense. But yeah, thank you guys for watching. I hope you have a great night or day or whatever. Bye, love you.